All right, let's talk about temperature scales. A temperature is a way to indicate, it's a measurement of how hot or how cold something is. The units that you're probably familiar with are degrees Fahrenheit or degrees Celsius. We use the little degree symbol, and degrees F would be Fahrenheit, degrees C would be degrees Celsius. If you grew up in the United States, we use the Fahrenheit for everything. Well, scientists use Celsius, as does most of the rest of the world. So we have to learn how to use the Celsius temperature scale. Let's talk about a couple of issues with the scale, sort of the history of it. Fahrenheit scale roughly goes, if we think about 0 to 100, 0 degrees Fahrenheit is roughly the coldest it gets in most of the habitable places on the planet. 100 degrees Fahrenheit is roughly as warm as it gets on most of the habitable places on this planet. Now, you know that it does get below 0 degrees Fahrenheit. It does get above 100 degrees, and I did it wrong. It does get above 100 degrees Fahrenheit on the planet, but these are essentially the range of climates that we see in places where a lot of people live. If we think about water on the Fahrenheit scale, water will freeze at 32 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm not trying to do this to scale too much, so the scale is a little weird. So at 32 degrees Fahrenheit, that's where water freezes. Water boils at 212 degrees Fahrenheit. So that's kind of what we're looking at as far as the scale for Fahrenheit. If we look at the scale for Celsius, we see that water freezes at 0 degrees Celsius on the Celsius scale, and it boils at 100 degrees Celsius on the Celsius scale. And that's roughly, that's one of the reasons why we use it. Water is a very common reagent. It's a common temperature bath, if you will. We use it a lot in the laboratory. We have a lot of aqueous solutions. There are a lot of times we use water sort of as a temperature modifier. And so going from 0 to 100 for water is one of the beautiful things about the Celsius temperature scale. So we see that 100 degrees Celsius is the same degree of hotness as 212 Fahrenheit. 0 degrees Celsius is the same degree coldness, if you will, as 32 degrees Fahrenheit. We must be able to convert between Celsius and Fahrenheit in order to be good scientists, because we often, again, in the United States, we often see temperatures in degrees Fahrenheit. So you need to sort of get a feel for them. There are several ways to do this conversion. There are lots of formulas out there, but here is a method that I like to use to convert between Celsius and Fahrenheit, and it makes a lot of sense to me. If we think in terms of unit conversions, hopefully you've already done a lot of practicing with your unit conversions. The Celsius temperature scale, as I go from 0 to 100, there are 100 degrees in between these two values. But on the Fahrenheit temperature scale, between 32 and 212, there are 180 degree units. So our degrees aren't the same. A 1 degree change is not the same on the two temperature scales. Another thing we notice, and it would be off this scale, if we go down to negative 40 degrees Celsius, that's where it overlaps with the Fahrenheit temperature scale. That would be negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit. Those two are exactly the same temperature. So our zeros don't line up on the two temperature scales. Our zeros line up at negative 40 degrees. So negative 40 degrees Celsius is the same as negative 40 degrees Fahrenheit. So we can't just do a direct unit conversion where we would do one conversion unit between the two. We have to take into account that our zeros aren't in the same place. We do want to look at the degree comparison, and as we look at 180 degrees Fahrenheit is the same change as 100 degrees Celsius, that reduces down to 9 degrees Fahrenheit is the same change as 5 degrees Celsius. Do you see what I did there? I reduced 180 equals 100 down to 9 equals 5. So there is my unit conversion. That's what I'm going to use to convert between Fahrenheit and Celsius, but I can't just use it in one simple step because my zeros don't line up. So here are the three steps to convert between degrees Celsius and degrees Fahrenheit. And it doesn't matter which direction you're going, the method works. The first step in the method is to add 40 degrees to whichever temperature is your starting place. We'll practice one of these so you can see these steps in practice. Add 40 degrees, and that's to get us up to zero, technically. Step number two is we'll use the conversion factor, 9 degrees Fahrenheit equals 5 degrees Celsius, to convert from the unit that we're given to the unit that we desire. We would use this as a ratio. It would either be 9 degrees Fahrenheit over 5 degrees Celsius or vice versa, depending on which unit we were given to start with and which unit we were going to. And then step number three is to subtract 40 degrees to essentially undo what we did in the first step, but to get us back to our zero point. For example, let's say we have 74 degrees Fahrenheit and we want to convert it to degrees Celsius. Step number one, add 40 degrees. So 74 plus 40 is 114. I am still in degrees Fahrenheit. The 74 was degrees Fahrenheit. I am still in degrees Fahrenheit. Step number two, in order to convert it to Celsius, I want how many degrees Celsius equals 114 degrees Fahrenheit. And so my conversion factor would need degrees Fahrenheit on the bottom, degrees Celsius on the top for my units to line up correctly. The 9 goes with the degrees Fahrenheit, the 5 goes with the degrees Celsius. I would plug that into my calculator. You don't want to round this, you want to keep this in your calculator. And I get 63.333, etc. Now at this point I do have degrees Celsius, but it's not my final answer because I need to perform step number three. I need to subtract 40. So I've got my 63.333 minus the 40. And when I plug that into my calculator, I end up with, that's an equal sign, 23 degrees Celsius. Since you are adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing, a good rule of thumb for your sig figs is to use the same number of decimal places as your original value. This original temperature did not have any decimal places, so my final answer after the conversion should not have any decimal places. If my original value had one decimal place, I would go ahead and round to one decimal place on my converted answer. And that's just a good rule of thumb. So 74 degrees Fahrenheit is 23 degrees Celsius.